succeedschool.com. Learn to succeed.
Cell differentiation and specialization. You were once just a single fertilized egg cell, a zygote. This single cell began to divide by mitosis, making identical copies of itself, forming a ball of a few identical cells called an embryo. These cells eventually became the huge variety of cells present in your body today, but they all started out the same. We say they were undifferentiated. Eventually, these cells began to specialize for different functions. We say they became differentiated, controlled by genes turning on and off. Most of the cells in your body are differentiated and specialized, though even as adults, most animals continue to produce a very small number of undifferentiated stem cells, which can divide into other types of cells. These may lead to medical breakthroughs in the future. Specialization makes cells better suited to specific jobs, with unique subcellular features. Muscle cells can contract, making them good for moving things. Nerve cells are very long, making them good at transmitting signals. Sperm cells have a tail, allowing them to propel themselves. Ciliated epithelial cells have tiny hair-like structures to sweep dust, bacteria, and mucus back out of the lungs. Unlike animals, many plant cells, found in the meristems, are able to differentiate throughout the life of the plant. Plants also have specialized cells, including root hair cells with large surface area for absorbing water and no chloroplast because they get no light, xylem cells which lose their end walls to form a lignin-strengthened tube for transporting water and minerals, and phloem cells which form sieve tubes and companion cells for transporting food. For a more detailed explanation of cell differentiation and specialization, please click this video. To see the whole Lightning Biology playlist, please click here, and please click here to subscribe.